one who gives love versus one who makes us earn his love. The one who gives us compassion versus one who just judges. And God encourages us to change, to love, to grow. Katie and Michael, that's what your marriage is all about. It's about the right relationship with each other and with God. A relationship of compassion, encouragement, growth, love, and hope between the two of you and your family and friends. And as we gather on this beautiful day, to all the friends and family who have gathered here, most of us are familiar with these beautiful words of Paul, either taken from Corinthians or in today's case, pulled from his letter to the Colossians. This particular community was teaching some strange ideas regarding how we should care and treat one another. So Paul sat there and wrote this eloquent letter about love. He was instructing them how to live together as a community. So I ask you, this community here, to take those words to heart, make them a prayer, and give them back to this couple. I'd ask this to be the strive to be the very definition of love for them. Be filled with heartfelt compassion, kindness, gentleness, and patience. Always bearing with one another, and always forgiving one another. It's what Paul is asking the Colossians. It's what Christ asks of all of us. As if we live this way, with this couple, with one another, we give them gifts that they're very eager to share. What Paul calls the bond of perfection, which is love. Katie and Michael, it's my prayer that you'll give those gifts a special place in your heart and your home. It's my prayer that those gifts will return time and time again to everyone who comes into your life. And if you do that, love will grow, hope will endure, and the story of creation will come. I invite you to come forward as you begin this journey. Catherine and Michael, we have come together in this beautiful church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister in this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Catherine and Michael, have you come here freely without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? And will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and practice it, and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Michael, take you, Catherine, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I love you. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Catherine, take you, Michael, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. God has joined no one. No one. Close. Lord, bless these rings and consecrate Michael and Catherine and their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Catherine, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So she's anxious. Now it's your turn. Michael, take this ring as a sign of my love. Spirit. Amen. I thought we'd see.